Hello, everybody. I'd like to welcome you here tonight. It's not starting. I'm not part of the ceremony. It is our fourth ceremony, and as they say, we have left the best for last. So it is also a ceremony that's it's been people have been here all day. It's been great, and it's really one of the interesting things. As we've done this format of multiple ceremonies, we've always left this group of students from these programs last, because there is something that is an energy of the students in these programs that are here tonight. So we hope that you will help us bring that energy tonight by applauding and screaming and creaming, everything. We gotta make this fun. But now a little bit serious, I have to just say a few little things. So prior to starting tonight, I just wanna mention that this is the largest graduation ceremony in the college's history, with 460 grads present through four ceremonies today. To ensure everyone's safety, I'd like to remind you of the procedures in the event, the unlikely event, that there is an evacuation that is needed and an alarm goes off. There are emergency exits. I guess this is where I pretend I'm on an airplane, on both sides. There are also exits at the back of the building, up the stairs. So please use the exit that's closest to you and proceed in an orderly fashion. Avant de commencer la cérémonie de remise des diplômes de ce soir, je tiens à préciser qu'il s'agit de la plus grande cérémonie de remise des diplômes de l'histoire du collège avec 460 diplômés présents aujourd'hui. Pour assurer la sécurité de tous, je voudrais vous rappeler les procédures à suivre en cas d'évacuation. Il y a des sorties sur les deux côtés, puis il y a des sorties en arrière aussi. Ça fait que utilisez les sorties les plus proches de vous et procédez d'une manière ordonnée. So thank you very much. We'll be starting in a couple of minutes, and have a great evening.
Today's joyful event honors the graduates for successfully completing the requirements for their chosen studies. Congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
everyone. Welcome to the hottest ticket in town. It's a full house today. People were reselling the tickets outside, if you probably noticed, triple the price. It's a beautiful night for everybody. Look at them. They are beautiful, aren't they? They look amazing. They look amazing. And you look amazing. So let me start with you. So let me thank you for choosing Champlain Saint-Lambert. As you can notice, you made the right choice, right? You must be so happy. These guys worked super hard to reach this objective today. This is just the tip of the iceberg, but all the work behind the scenes, all the work with the amazing teachers that we have, with the support staff, the professionals, today is a culmination of that. Today is the day, so I hope you give them the night free, right? Right? I hope so. It's a Friday night for everybody, well, at least for them. You gotta go to work tomorrow, but for them it's Friday night. So, congratulations. So let's begin the ceremony by our land acknowledgement, very important to the college and very important to me. With clear minds and respect, we would like to acknowledge that Champlain College Saint-Lambert is located on the unceded lands of the Ganyengehega Nation. The Ganyengehega people are acknowledged as the custodians of the lands and water on which we gather. Jogé, Montreal, has long been a place of gathering for indigenous peoples, and we recognize the diversity of indigenous people who now reside on the land. We continuously recognize the importance of fostering positive relationships with indigenous people of the land and their future generations. Myself, as an immigrant kid that came to this land more than 30 years ago, in time I also became a custodian of this land because it has never been about ownership, but about respect to this beautiful land and to the people that have gathered here for hundreds of years and will gather for 1,000 more. So thank you. Without much further ado, let's invite Yves Rainville, Acting Director General.
Oh, dear guests, parents and family, faculty members, of employees of Saint-Lambert, colleagues, Monsieur Chouin, mais surtout vous tous, finissant Saint-Lambert 2023. Je suis très heureux de pouvoir partager ce moment-là avec vous. Ne vous inquiétez pas, je vais être bref, la soirée est pour vous. For the past 20 years, I've worked at Champlain at the Administrative Services in Sherbrooke. Although it is rewarding to know that your work contributes directly to the success of the college, it is rare to see the real results, your success. For the past 4 months, I've been given the privilege of being the Interim Director General for Champlain Regional College. That includes the opportunity of attending graduations. So being here today brings to life why all of us who work at Champlain are proud to do so. It's seeing you succeed and prepare for the next step on your journey. Thank you for that privilege. On behalf of the entire college, congratulations and best wishes for a wonderful, fulfilling life. Bravo.
Thank you, Yves. To continue the ceremony, please let's invite Anthony Singelis, Dean of Curriculum and Faculty Development. Anthony.
Thank you, Alex, and welcome to everyone in our audience. It is my pleasure to be able to welcome the graduates to the stage. This is our fourth graduation ceremony today, but it is one that I have a personal connection to. As they heard earlier, 43 years ago to the day, at John Abbott College, I graduated, and I was on the podium at 107 giving a commencement speech. I had a double deck at that time. Two of the programs from which I graduated are being celebrated during this period. One was commerce, and the other one was then called film studies. We now know it as media. Not that I wasn't interested in studying liberal arts, but, it was a double deck. At the time, we were all wearing the same blue gowns that you're wearing now. We were in an auditorium like this one, but without any air conditioning. It was hot, humid, and it was a Sunday. But because of that connection, I am particularly pleased to be here today, and I am especially pleased that this group is our final group of the day. So congratulations. While we're here celebrating your graduation from CEGEP, it's only the beginning of an extraordinary adventure that I know you will all be taking. I hope that you will believe in the power that you have to make a difference. It's your generation that will shape the future, and that's going to fix some of the things that my generation might have messed up. And may you go forward in whatever path you choose to follow with purpose, passion, and an unwavering belief that you can indeed change the world, because you will. Congratulations to you all. Without further ado, we're going to begin our presentation of diplomas to our graduates. The first group is going to be Commerce. I call to the stage Marina Chernegovskaya, who will help me with the presentation. And ladies and gentlemen, this is our first graduate of this block and our first Commerce graduate. Give a loud applause to Louis Emeric Xavier Adelade. Our next graduate is Elizabeth Alain. Elizabeth is also the recipient of the Prix d'Excellence en Français en reconnaissance de la réussite scolaire élevée et de l'engagement personnel à l'apprentissage. Our next graduate is Louis-Philippe Bergevin-Lassonde. Sophia Victoria Bentacourt-Rangel. Marina, merci pour votre assistance. We're going to continue with the presentations. Amanda Perry, could you please come to the stage? Our next graduate is Zoe Charbonneau. Rosalie Cyr. Félix Deslandes. Divine Dabula. Kenshin Fontaine. Gaël Gaudreau-Lamolé. Megan Girard. Dylan Haley. Gavin Hu. Favor Ehinom and Bendion. Favor is also the recipient of the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Environmental Citizenship. All right, thank you, Amanda. We're going to continue with our presentation. Christine Hayes, could you come to the stage, please? Still with Commerce, Marjorie Jacques. Guillermo James Delgado. Vidu Curler. Gabriel Laguna Estevez. Mathieu Larose. Henri Leduc. Jean-Christophe Lemieux-Rosignol. Samuel Lévesque. And to join Christine Hayes on the stage, I ask Malcolm Harper. Our next graduate, Samuel Lewis. Ladies and gentlemen, this will be long. Samuel, walk slowly. Samuel is the recipient of the Marjorie Langshire English Prize in recognition of the highest academic achievement in English, the Mathematics Prize in recognition of the highest academic achievement in mathematics for social sciences or law, civilization, and math, and the Social Science Commerce Prize for the highest academic achievement in commerce. I'm not finished. And Social Science Economics Award, Economics Certificate of Merit for the highest academic achievement in economics. Thank you, Christine. Continue with our Commerce graduates. Malcolm and I wish to call Kevin Lin. Emilienne Martel. Meg Stephanie Martinez. Joseph Maxant. Joshua Natal. Chloe Oliver. Alicia Michelle Onescu. Juliana Piazza. Simon Picard. Charlotte Rave. Emily Rioux. And our final graduate from Commerce, Sarah Veroneau. And Malcolm, I ask you to stay on the stage for one last presentation from an earlier ceremony that we missed. Social science psychology option, Nuria Kamsu Toshe Naba. Thank you, Malcolm. And we are now continuing with arts, literature, and communication, language, and culture. I call the stage Gervasio. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Okay, Gervasio. You're applauding his spiffy haircut? Yeah, okay, I thought so. Our first graduate is Diana Emily Castro Gomez. Elizabeth Lapuente. Tasha Ligi. Megan McLaughlin. Ariana Mia Musacchio Albuquerque. Manon, I don't know if it's supposed to be in English or in French, because they haven't indicated it. Doesn't matter, okay. Manon Nicholas. Manon is also the recipient of the Language and Culture Prize in recognition of the highest academic achievement in the Language and Culture program. Sandrine Ouellette. And our final graduate from Language and Culture is Anne-Sophie Pilon. Ladies and gentlemen, our graduates from Language and Culture. Thank you, Giovasio. We now continue with digital arts and new media. Pascal, Wen, to the stage, please. It's Vanessa? They didn't correct it. Sorry, Vanessa Vaughn. Everyone, this is Vanessa Vaughn. Vanessa, our first graduate is Philippe Beauchesne. Olivia Brown. Vania Camila Castro Jimenez. Andrea Zveltlana and Tingjin Bonilla. Evan Graham. Lynette Samantha Lee. Eduardo Miranda Mapelli. Eduardo is also the recipient of the Media Certificate of Merit in recognition of outstanding abilities in digital arts and new media. Aaron Ozer. Renz Rovasi Rosas. And our final graduate from Digital Arts and New Media is Carolyn Wang. I give you digital arts and new media. Thank you, Vanessa. Pascal, it's now your turn. We continue film and new media. Our first graduate, Luis Eduardo Alonso Paz. Alia Beauchemin. Sarah Beaulieu. I'm calling to the stage for this next presentation, Christine Hayes, as we present the diploma to Isaac Blay Hayes. Justine Boucher-Marsan. Andrea Caceres. Gabrielle Castonguay. Quinn Conobry. Eloise Coutu. Thomas Léo Demers. Camille Consolves. Corey Giamarti. Jose David Ibanez. Amelia Malorny. Katharina Pyers. And our final graduate in film and new media is Sandrine Poulin. Sandrine is also the recipient of the Media Certificate of Merit in recognition of outstanding abilities in film and new media. Thank you, Pascal. Our graduates from film and new media. On to Law and Civilization. Was that for Bruce? Okay. Bruce, could you accompany me on the stage? Bruce, our first graduate from Law and Civilization is Grace Victoire Amidaho. en ballon. Joannex, it's your turn. Joannex Benetis Alfaro. Frederic Cote. Manuel da Silva. Clara Delil. Kirit Gunman. Kirit is also the recipient of the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Democracy and Social Movements. Lila Klein. Nitya Masahena. Nitya is also the recipient of the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Critical Race Studies and the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Democracy and Social Movements. Valerie Nicole Mejia. Last one for Bruce is going to be Kathleen Pavel Morzon. Actually, I stand corrected. We have one other. The last one for Bruce will be Ivana Rose Marley Moranci. Thank you, Bruce. Marina, de retour l'estrade. Our next graduate is Isis Oliveira Guimarães. Isis has also been awarded the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Democracy and Social Movements. Et Marina, c'est fini. Merci. Bruce, I need you back on stage. We are having a lot of switcheroos. I call our next graduate, Gabrielle Perron. Gabrielle is the winner of the Gail Sowerby Prize in recognition of the highest academic achievement in the Law and Civilization program, and she is a Millennium Certificate of Merit awardee for Democracy and Social Movements. Darlie Pierre. Naël Pomerleau. Those are our graduates from Law and Civilization, but Bruce is staying on stage because we're continuing with Law, Civilization, and Mathematics. Our first graduate, Nyan Aries. Barbara Belyakova. Barbara Vera is the recipient of the Millennium Certificate of Merit for Democracy and Social Movements. Julie Bourbeau. Anis Daudoui. Sébastien Gélina Larin. Alexandra Matei. Mahi Rabassa. Last graduate from Law, Civilization, and Mathematics, but Bruce, I'm going to ask you to stay on the stage again, is Evan Sinclair. And to join Bruce, I'm going to ask all the faculty members who are on the stage to come up. We have two more graduates, and we're going to send them off together since they're the last two graduates for the day and the year. Coming from social science, the photographer is going to hate me. Coming from social science commerce, Lucas Larando. To everyone in the room, this is our final graduate from Commerce, Janina Napoleon. Thank you, faculty. I give you the graduates from Commerce, Liberal Arts, and Media. Congratulations to all. Back over to Alex.
But don't throw your hats yet. No. Everyone is doing well. Amazing night, right? Amazing the things that we can do here with great students, right? So if you have a second, third, fourth, fifth, or sixth child, nephew, niece, neighbor, don't hesitate. Bring him to Champlain. You know, greatness creates greatness. So congratulations, guys. Sure. You going to the second part of the ceremony. We're going to be calling Dawn Smith for the South Shore University Women's Club Award. Dawn, please.
Thank you. I've been asked to present this on behalf of the South Shore University Women's Club, and it is an award presented to a female student who has achieved academic success and has shown proof of interest in subjects or activities that advance the status of women. This year, the award will be given to Nithaya Mahanasan.
For our next award, let's welcome Vanessa Vaughn to present the Dean Chi Shire Memorial Award.
The Dean Chi Shire Memorial Award is named in honor of the first chair of the Digital Arts Program at Champlain. It is given to a student for excellence in studio arts. This year, it's my pleasure that the award goes to Philippe Beauchesn.
Next award, please welcome Céline Bourgeois to present the Anna Ackless Support Staff Union Award.
The Anna Ackless Support Staff Union Award is presented to an outstanding student who has been involved in volunteer work on and off campus, and who has maintained a good overall academic standing. It is a pleasure this year to award this to Kirit Gumman.
For the next award, let's invite Dean Howie to the front for the Joy Smith Athletic Merit Award.
It is my pleasure tonight to present the Joy Smith Athletic Merit Award, which is presented annually to an outstanding member of the Champlain Cavaliers Intercollegiate Athletic Program who has maintained an above average academic record while pursuing excellence on the sports field and also being involved in other areas of the college. This year I'm presenting the award to someone who I had the opportunity to meet before she was a student. She was walking around the college with her mother in a sort of, I guess, a recruiting trip, and she was sort of checking things out. She was considering other CJEPs and also Champlain. We had a conversation, and she wanted to ensure that she could be involved in the athletics program and be on the women's basketball team and also be able to diversify and be involved in student life. And she's left her mark on student life, in academics, and on the basketball court. It is my pleasure to present the award to Mahe Rabessa.
Thank you.
for the next two awards, let's invite our beloved president of the CSA, Rafin Islam Khan, for the CSA Student Involvement Bursary. Thank you.
All right, how's everyone doing? All right, I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. I know by saying this, I'm making it longer, so I'm gonna. So, the CSA Student Involvement Award is given to students who have demonstrated a great amount of involvement in the community, whether it be at Champlain or outside of the school. We have two winners for this award, so I'll welcome our first one first, and then after I've done everything here, we'll get the other one up here. So, for the first person who won the award, it is, drumroll please, yeah, Kirit Guman. I hope I said that right. Now, for the second winner, another drum roll, please. Nithya Mahasenan. I hope I said that right.
Andre LeBlanc Student Life Award. Let's invite Juanita Jones to the podium.
The Andre E. LeBlanc Student Life Prize is given for an outstanding contribution to the quality of student life on campus while maintaining high academic success. The recipient of this award is a true community builder. As a member of the Cavalier basketball team, member of the MCC BLAM team where I met this individual, creator of Diversity in Arts, where we just found out about half an hour ago that the Diversity in Arts program succeeded to be finalists in the Force Avenir, which is across the réseau of colleges. That's wonderful news. And they have succeeded to build lasting bridges and pave the way for what it means to be a leader as a student athlete on campus. So since Rafin started the drum roll, why don't we go on with it? So the winner is Mahe Rabessa.
For the next three awards, which are Language and Culture Award, Digital Arts and New Media Award, and the Film and New Media Award, let's invite Mr. Sylvain Cassavant de Télévision Rive-Sud.
Thanks to you. Thanks to Champlain College. First of all, TVRS is a nonprofit organization. Une télévision communautaire qui encourage les étudiants, évidemment, à expérimenter ce qu'ils ont appris ici. Thanks. First of all, the TVRS Scholarship for Language and Culture is awarded to a student, a good academic standing, intending to pursue university studies, and who has demonstrated involvement and commitment to the building of community within or outside college setting. The student is Tasha Léger. The second one, this scholarship is awarded to a graduate student in digital arts pursuing higher education. Throughout their courses, they have demonstrated a commitment to learning, have made a positive contribution to collective learning. The award goes to Vania Camilla Castro. Cette bourse est attribuée à un étudiant diplômé du programme Cinéma et des nouveaux médias qui poursuit des études supérieures tout au long de son cursus. Cet étudiant a fait preuve d'une volonté d'apprendre et a apporté une contribution positive à l'apprentissage collectif et s'est approprié ses projets créatifs. The graduate is Julien Rose. Julien is not attending tonight. You're not there. Thanks to you.
For the last award of the night, let's invite Yves Ville to present the Champlain Regional College Board of Governors Merit Award and the Academic Medal of the Governor General of Canada.
So the Academic Medal of the Governor General of Canada, as well as the Champlain Regional College Board of Governors Merit Award, are presented to the graduating student with the highest academic average. This year, the award goes to Samuel Lewis.
Close the ceremony on the night, let's invite our director of the Constituent College, Don Shiwen.
Woo!
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Free souvenir. Before I start, you're much quieter than the students in the last session last year. I'm like, oh, I don't know what's wrong. I think some of you must have laryngitis or something. But first of all, let me start by thanking all of the people on the stage. Nos amis, des visages sud. The chair of our governing board, Don Smith. Our acting director general, Yves Ville. Better not leave out the students, but I was going to say something nice about the CSA after, so I'll come back to you, okay? Good. The rest of you, the people who are here are representative of the high level of quality, dedication, and commitment, and caring that Champlain brings to its students. And so, as we'll call them ambassadors for the moment, if we could have a round of applause for them, I'd appreciate it. Now, the last piece, maybe get me in trouble, but that's too bad. Because after tomorrow, it won't matter. I watched the affection that you all showed to Bruce Toombs. No, not you know, foolish. I mean, seriously. There's a connection there. Bruce is retiring, and we, yes, you probably all do, but I think we ought to take a moment, because his career here is extraordinary, the things he's done. I go all the way back to the IB in Nicaragua. My gosh, we had some interesting discussions about those and some challenges, but, you know, following all the things you've brought and done for this college, I just think we ought to say thank you to Bruce.
Bruce is retiring all the way to law school.
Yeah. And so you'll all be students together. Going to be an interesting gig, isn't it? Where the whole relationship thing changes. But seriously, thank you. The end of a ceremony. It's kind of bittersweet in a way. Because, yeah, there have been four of them, and it's starting to feel for some of the folks up on the stage like a marathon, not a sprint. But there's something that's magical about this day, this ceremony, and what it means, hopefully to you, but what it means to us, too. Because if we look at what a college is really all about, it's you folks. You're our raison d'etre, and I'll come back to that in a minute. One of the things I've done in the first three speeches that I'm going to do again is to ask you, if you're wearing a blue gown, or whatever they call these darn things, just stand up for a minute, would you? Yeah, don't everybody do anything else, because it's their work right now. Well, not yet. See, here's what's going to happen. Don't sit. Keep standing, please. Because here's the point. We spent a whole afternoon, the last portion of it, applauding you. But if I look on this whole two-thirds over here of the auditorium, I have this distinct impression that you wouldn't be there if they weren't here in many, many cases. Food, lodging, support, caring, 1,000 other things. So what I'd like you to do is join with me in a standing ovation for all of these folks here. So, Alex earlier talked about you guys get to pretend it's Friday night and not have to go home and do anything tomorrow. He's probably right. Please have a seat.
J'aimerais signaler les efforts des étudiants qu'ils ont choisi de poursuivre leurs études en anglais au Collège Champlain. Nous apprécions la confiance que vous nous avez accordée. Étudier dans une langue seconde demande la motivation, la persévérance et de la patience. Votre réussite est inspirante. Bravo.
Now, I've been saying this all afternoon, but this is really where it comes to the point, is that this ceremony today signals the end of our first 50 years as a college. And can there be any more appropriate, any better way to cap off this year than this, to publicly recognize the reason we exist? Student success, your success. Somewhere over the last 50 years, we've had about 35,000 graduates. And you look and you say, well, I guess I'm just a number, but that's not true. What we see is each one of you is unique. And all of you, every one of you who's here and everyone who's ever been here,
make Champlain a special place in whatever it was you brought, because nobody else but you can do that. As we celebrated our golden anniversary, I noticed something. A surprising number of graduates look back fondly on their time here, but in many cases not mentioning some specific incident, but rather memory of their experience, developing a passion for learning, being inspired, usually by a faculty member, to pursue a particular career or a pathway, or simply finding a place where they could feel at home, safe to grow and find themselves. And as I started to write this speech, a line from one of my favorite poets, Maya Angelou, kept coming back to me. She said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel." So, do you care how you're remembered? Does it really matter to you? The thing that she said, I think, goes even farther and cuts deeper, because studies have shown that our emotional experiences tend to be more memorable and influential than neutral or factual information. In other words, we're more likely to remember the way that someone has made us feel than the details of the event. As I was writing, I was struggling with this part of the thing. Well, how do I make it relevant? And a friend of mine, a very good friend, pointed out the yellow bench that's in front of Student Services. You see, the Yellow Bench Project was launched in April 2015 to continue the selfless acts of Lucas Fiorella, a Canadian student who suffered from depression for a good number of years. He suffered in secret. Lucas's family and his friends learned about his silent battle, but they also discovered his efforts to support other students who were suffering. A number of his friends and classmates reported that he took time out to reach each of them when he sensed their anxiety or depression. Each conversation started with a random hello, and in each case, Lucas provided the courage and acceptance needed for his peers to speak about their suffering with family members or professionals, which in turn prevented them from dropping out of school, hurting themselves, or worse. And I wonder, for all of us, all of you in blue, all of us on the stage, how many times we've walked by that bench without even noticing it. But could it be a symbol for something that you or I could do? And I say that, I know it's the end of your career, but an awful lot of people come back. And we sure hope you will. And if you walk by it, don't miss it. Perhaps it wouldn't be quite as dramatic as saving a life, but surely it could make a difference to somebody else. Earlier on, somebody mentioned to me that they'd sat there three or four times this year, and I have to confess, I didn't see them anytime I walked by, but they said nobody stopped to talk to them. And now we throw a challenge out to ourselves, and in a way to you, but not at the yellow bench, but anything that's similar, to reach out, to make a difference. How do you make people feel? Your words and actions, they don't need years to take effect. Rather, they can impact things right now. It can affect your careers, your personal and family relationships. It can make a difference to somebody you don't even know. On days like this, you know, we spend a lot of time talking about big things, big hopes, big dreams, big ambitions. And of course, that's wonderful, but how often is it we get home and by tomorrow, whatever it is we talked about was big here, it just fits into the regular conversation and gets lost. But this, what seems small, thinking about how we make people feel might be worth something considering. In fact, I challenge you to reflect more about that. Think about what you're doing or not doing, what you're saying or not saying. How does it impact others? Risk more. Concern about how you make people feel requires stepping out of your comfort zone, and it may result in your being disappointed or even rejected. finally, unless, and some of you with extraordinary talents you have will not have to worry about this, but unless you're incredibly successful or famous, what lives on after you? The memories that other people have of you. How you affected their lives, and yes, how you made them feel. What impact does this or could this have on your relationships? How do people feel about me? Can you and I, should we? Actually, never mind should we must do better in the way we deal with that. Not just as individuals, but you just turn on the TV, look around, and tell me that everything's fine in this world. And we can't all change all of the major problems, we can work at them. But we can sure make a difference to somebody else, and if we all do that, the world starts to change. And so, I invite you to think about it, to try it and see. As you leave here today, it is my deepest hope that you will take from Champlain memories that will last a lifetime, and that you will build good lives for yourselves. We are so proud and grateful that you chose us, that you brought your talent, your energy, and character. And from each of you, it's unique. You brought it to be the cornerstone of our launch of the next 50. We build it on what you've done this year and who you are, and we move forward from there. So we're so proud and grateful that you chose us, that you brought all of those things to Champlain. So I invite you to go from here and make great lives for yourselves. Please remember this. No matter where you go, what you do, you, each one of you, will be woven forever into the fabric of Champlain College. Again, thank you for making Champlain better, because you were a part of it. Congratulations. So before we will stand up and cheer you again. Before we do, I get handed a list of things I'm supposed to remember that are housekeeping. To the graduates, please don't forget to return your gowns to the place just outside the cafeteria after you got your pictures done. Say this to the first group, they all started to hand them back, and then the pictures were without this wonderful gown and cap that you have. So please don't forget, though. The photographer will be here for a while, so there's no rush to get in line for a picture. And I said to Raffin that I wanted to talk about the CSA. Your student association. They've been extraordinary this year. It's been wonderful working with you, Raffin, and with your team. And the reason that I'm mentioning them now is that they are sponsoring the photo booth. So all of the photos there are free, thanks to your student association. Yeah. And so, to our guests, we hope you will join us for a small reception in the cafeteria in honor of our, or should I say your, graduates. It's a great opportunity for some photos and a chance to mingle with faculty and staff. And so now, if you're in blue, please stand up again. Okay? So here's what we're going to do. Don't throw your hats yet. Let me just finish getting the sentence out. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Champlain Saint-Lambert's class of 2023. You can throw your hats now. So, what we're going to do to leave, the folks on the stage will head out. We'll ask the graduates to follow, and then if you wouldn't mind following the graduates, we can get out of here in a fairly orderly fashion without a major traffic jam. Thank you.